Symphony of Thank you. stands in the grounds of this hospital. It's just out there. You'll see it was quite a big branch. It's managed to get five instruments out of it. And it's really a remarkable tribute to Wilfred Owen and that whole lost generation of World War I. So over to Steve for a bit more about the instruments.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to move to this incredible thing. Really, the great child of Leo McLennan, and it's an honor to be here. It is what is still a commemoration of the most horrendous events that we've had a year ago. So, I'd just like to say thanks to the Christmas Hill Conference of the Lord. And this is the LA, I'm going to try to get the most of the
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
tune we're going to play is perhaps the most well-known tune at the time of the World War One. It's a very famous tune, you probably all know it. You're welcome to join us, sing along with us. This tune is Danny Boy. Wonderful group of people we have on the stage with us just now. It was so important, I think, at the start that we included young people in this concert, because at the end of the day, the mantle of remembrance is going to be passed down to them, and you know, it just wouldn't be the same if it was all adults. So we're so delighted and pleased to have George Watson's College Symphony Orchestras with us today, and led by David Elliott, the head of music at George Watson. So I'd like to welcome them all in now, and please give them a round of applause. Thank you.
So good afternoon, everybody. As you'll see from your programme, we're going to play a piece for you written by Cecil Coles. Cecil Coles was born in 1888 and was a pupil at George Watson's College. He studied in London and Edinburgh, and then got a position working at the Royal Opera in Stuttgart in Germany, returning to his country just before the First World War began in 1914. The piece we're going to play to you is from a suite of pieces he wrote, the suite is called Behind the Lines. And I think this is a really interesting and moving story, that this composer who was working in the trenches of the First World War, actually composing music while he was sitting in the terrible conditions of the First World War, still thinking up this wonderful music and writing it down. And some of the scores that he wrote at that time are actually splattered with the mud of the trenches. Extraordinary. He was a great friend of the composer Gustav Holst, and everyone thought that Cecil Coles was online to become the next great British composer when he was tragically killed by a sniper bullet as he was working as a stretcher bearer in 1918. On the back page of the original score of the piece we're going to play, it says simply, the 4th of February, 1918, in the field. So you can imagine for us, this is really quite an emotional thing, that we are playing this music exactly 100 years ago this was composed, and we're playing it now, a group of pupils from the same school that Cecil Coles attended. So hope you enjoy this performance we're going to give you now of Cortege.
Thank you.
time, so you're going to get a couple of minutes of us giving some background to it. When I first put out the idea that we should bring musicians together in the afternoon of remembrance to as a symbol of cooperation and creativity conquering conflict, the response from musicians was absolutely fantastic. Musicians across the globe contacting. Thor and I worked together closely on Wilfred Owen's Edinburgh event throughout 2014 to 2018. We had a conversation about what music would be appropriate to be played across the globe. Now, you've heard two pieces of that music today. You've heard the lads of Clinton's Hill, which is very much an Edinburgh and a Scotland tragedy. You've heard the Battle of the Somme, which is very much so a British tragedy. But there are many, many other tragedies from the First World War. Verdun is France's tragedy. Kaiser's Pact is Germany's tragedy. Gallipoli, Anzac tragedy. That list goes on and on and on for each country who have their own sorrows and their own tales to tell. And Thoren kindly agreed to compose a new piece scored by the Wilfred Owen violin, which is called Armistice. He's going to tell us a little bit about the inspiration for the piece we're about to hear.
Yes, so, well, it's exciting times. We need to get a big countdown going for New Year. We're going to actually do a countdown, 10 to 1. But before, we've got a few minutes to spare before we get onto that. So Armistice, so I was really struck by Neil's idea, which I think everybody who we've spoken to about this idea has just been really taken with it and thought, wow, what a great idea. And I was delighted to be asked to write a piece of music. So I went away. And it's funny because in 2016, because I like to come, you know, think about writing new tunes quite a lot when I'm playing the violin, I'll sort of think about new compositions. And the theme for Armistice, actually, I first recorded it on my mobile phone, which I found the other week there in 2016 at the start. And I always associated it with Armistice for some reason. Don't know why, but it just sort of felt like Armistice to me. And this is well before we had sort of the idea of this concert. So when Neil asked me if I'd write a piece, that was initially my sort of go-to. I thought, no, this is fitting, this theme here. And then just expanded on that, really. So it starts, when all the instruments come in, it's in my mind, it's like all the different countries and the different voices entering into war. And they kind of weave in and out, at times harmoniously, at times not. And they build a sort of tension about the growing of war. Then the piece builds and builds until we have the sort of the climax of war, until armistice, and then there'll be a bit of silence, which is a silent after the cessation of fire. And then what comes back is the heartbeat of mankind as the first thing that starts back, and then the bells, 11 bells for armistice. And then that comes into church bells, so it starts the celebration back home. I imagine just the bells ringing out, and a jig starts up on the violin. But then there's a moment of celebration, but I felt, how long can you celebrate knowing the tragedy and the loss that has just taken place? So and then it starts to break apart and break down and comes back to the original theme. And the last moment, the last bit of the tune, is the each of the instruments come in with a similar theme, and to me that's the remembrance, the mantle of remembrance being passed down from generation to generation to generation. And that's really why we collaborated on this project. We don't want to forget these men, that generation, and we want to make this the first. This will be the first of what will become an annual concert for armistice and for peace in the world. Already, we have, as we speak, countries from all around the world joining us. In fact, they're watching right now. They're watching you all on the screen when you get going. So. It's fantastic to have everyone from all around the world. Maybe should we say hello to everyone around the world?
Should we just explain very briefly? We have a technical team at the back, and I want to give our absolute thanks for their 100 years ago technology used to harm mankind. And 100 years on, we have a technology team at the back that led by Associate Professor Paul Ferguson, who's connecting us now with the world. So I think a round of applause to the team at the back. America to Ypres. We have a group of school children underneath the men in here to speak with
their violins at the ready. They'll be playing along with us and broadcasting out on Belgian TV. And then various other locations, multiple locations in Turkey. We already have some videos uploaded from young people who have played from Gallipoli, the battlefields there. We have Kosovo, as we all connected in. Various locations across the USA, and then various places that we just don't know. We know they're taking part, but we don't know where they are, but we know that they're playing with us at exactly the same time. So there's something quite nice about that. You're part of a unique experience today.
One minute.
It's a farce again. You're part of a unique experience today. As we say, this is only the start. We want to build on this at a time just now where we know the world is fragmenting again, and it's only through our own actions and our own connectivity others in other countries that we can rebel against that and make sure that the world connects in peace and harmony. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted you're all here today to hear Thoren Ferguson's piece Armistice, which will be played by the Symphony Orchestra, and also online we shall see Tynecastle High School students who play on a live link from Merkiston. Please enjoy.
And hello to everyone around the world who's watching. Let's give them a big hello.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to...
Who's next? Okay, we've got Lou Marshall, Louise Marshall, the Provost, the Lord Provost Piper is going to play a tune now for us. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here today.
got space to turn around, as you can see.
Huge thank you to Thoren Ferguson, the composer, and also not only a fine composer, but absolutely wonderful fiddler. Thoren, thank you very much. And his partner in time over the last number of years, Lewis Kelly. Catering teams, we have the support teams, an absolutely phenomenal collaboration, all in the spirit of what today is about. To Team Napier, thank you very, very much. For those who are here, I know there's a number of military personnel here, past or present here today, and they will know that every major campaign needs a good second lieutenant. The whole of an operation relies upon second lieutenants. And today, there are very few army battlefield promotions these days. That's something to look at. Why is there so few battlefield promotions these days? But today, if we were given promotions, we would absolutely give a third pip to this gentleman. He's been the captain of this operation here today at Craiglockhart. Such an apt place for us to hold this concert. Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you to put your hands together for Mr. Gary C. Support on this event and on the last 4 years of commemoration activity has been unstinting, and hopefully today's been enjoyable, moving, but also hopefully a fire in the belly to continue to do something in a world that embraces both creativity. and cooperation so that we can cooperate more effectively. We have seen the results when those things break down, and today we remember them. We remember all of them who fell in that horrendous conflict. Ladies and gentlemen, please do now join us in a reception kindly sponsored by Edinburgh Napier University, our host, a chance for us to reflect on today, the 11th of November. But the 11th of November, we're 100 years on, we make a pledge and a commitment to the next 100 years and the world we want to be. Please connect in with friends who you've met before, and please also reach out to people who you've not met and make some new connections as we gather downstairs. We're going to be picked out by Lou Marshall. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much.